grew up in the Bay Area, like around San Francisco and San Jose. My family were big record listeners. You know, they'd have all their friends over and drink wine, listen to records, so that's all I ever did. Remember, I would like stare at like a picture of Fleetwood Mac, and I was just so fascinated with the guitars. It was a lot of like, before I had any vision of what people looked like playing, it was the pose, you know, Pete Townsend, or I got taken to a lot of concerts before I even knew who they were. So I saw Bruce Springsteen before I knew who Bruce Springsteen was and stuff like that. I think I saw the Rolling Stones when I was like 10 years old. The first guitar that I got was a Les Paul copy, because I was obsessed with Les Pauls. And then I got an actual like 82 Les Paul, and I just was obsessed with it and would like clean it constantly. And I was learning everything that I could through guitar magazines. Early 2000s, I was started playing bass. And it was just purely out of like playing guitar, I just kept being more obsessed with like rhythm sections. So if I liked a band like The Police, I only cared about what the drummer and the bass player were doing, or, you know. That was it. It was like, I was really obsessed with like Paul Simonon and Tina Weymouth and Peter Hook, Kim Gordon. It was like, I just became like focused on like who the bass players were. Like I played guitar for years and I would be like, oh yeah, I can play bass. I know how to, I know the notes. And then I had to learn how to play with a drummer. So it was like learning how to play bass properly. From there, I just started playing with different artists. So I played with Quinn Quang. I played with this band called the Kidney Thieves for a little while. And then like a lot of my own bands, and then playing with Manson. That was like really it. And I was playing Thunderbirds and Manson. That was like the sound. It was Thunderbirds. Before I knew them or anything like that, I would see Twiggy on stage playing a Thunderbird, and I just have always loved the body shape of the Thunderbird. I just think it's the coolest. Twiggy was like, look, this is the sound, and he was gonna play guitar. So he said, but Thunderbird's the sound, that's the sound. And I didn't really understand that because I just thought, it's just a bass, you know? But then when I played it and heard how there's such a distinctly different sound than most basses. Those songs are real rhythmic based. I mean, some of those songs, the bass part leads the song. So if you think like Dope Show or something like that, I think that's such a good rhythmic way to play, you know, good different style than most people realize, you know. After I played with Manson for a few years, from there, then it turned into like, I got asked to play with Peter Hook. So to play bass alongside someone who influenced me is like the wildest, you know, playing Joy Division songs and New Order songs with the guy who plays bass, and I'm playing bass with him. Those songs really lead, are led by the bass. It's a different, it's not like playing to the drummer. He's playing like a guitar part or a keyboard part. I had to learn how to kind of unlearn what I learned with of being a rhythmic player, you know? And then to be playing alongside of him and like see him looking at me, and we're playing together, playing the same lines, and it is absolutely the most surreal experience. And I had like some heavy moments on stage with them where, you know, we're playing Atmosphere or some song, or, you know, She's Lost Control. And I would have to play She's Lost Control, like the, you know, the part while he sang, and he would look at me and I would just be like, what is happening? This is the newest Thunderbird, and actually I'm kind of upset because I really want it, but it's definitely, it's interesting because, you know, obviously Thunderbirds are known for having longer scale, and the fretboard, like the flatness of the fretboard is actually what I really enjoy a lot. It's just a thinner neck. I guess it would be kind of similar to a jazz bass, but even, it actually feels even thinner. I have a Thunderbird at home, and I actually was playing it before I came here, and this actually feels a lot better. So whatever Gibson's doing right now, I'm actually quite happy with. But yeah, this thing feels amazing. Tonally, this is one thing that a lot of bass players don't think about. Rolling off tones, or balancing these pickups a little more, or, you know, to not just be like 10. I mean, the big thing with I think is important with a lot of basses is to find that specific tone. So if you think about, to be able to roll those tone knobs off, to switch the pickups, to, you can hear the the warmness, and then you can bright it up. But then the tone knob. That real Dazed and Confused sound, yeah. But then you can be like. So you got a humbucker pickup with ceramic magnets that just delivers and has that classic Thunderbird sound. The neck pickup is a rhythm pickup, but the bridge pickup is a lead pickup. But that's, again, like with using these knobs to not have everything just on, but actually balance them and find these tonality differences. I think that the Thunderbird is actually one of the coolest shapes ever. This is actually one of the reasons why when I played bass, I was like, I want a Thunderbird, because when people put this on, it has such a distinct look and a different, it makes you play a really specific way. It's hard to describe that, but it really does. It makes you play a different way. It's like a spaceship or something, you know? One thing that I learned with Peter Hook was, I remember going to rehearse with him, and he said, and I was making some mistakes. I was just nervous, and he was like, why do you play bass? Like, why do you play music? And I was like, well, because I love it. And he goes, well, then you love it, you gotta enjoy it. You have to have fun. And that's all it really is. It's like, if you're playing and you're enjoying it, that's all that matters. And that's kind of what I always like think about. Like, he was saying like, oh, you know, we're gonna be playing in front of thousands of people. I'll make mistakes, you'll make mistakes. Everyone's gonna make their little moments, but you gotta enjoy it. Part of like what, when I think about like, I can't believe that I still get to play music, is that I get to actually still enjoy it.